have at least maximum of 8 persons along with us up there. I'm not talking about those that were denied access to the court premises. We are outside trying to resolve that issue. Because we can't continue this manner. We have people that came from all the way from Aba today.
Yes.
We have a person who is representing Igbo lawyers here.
Yes.
He was not allowed access to the court. We have people who are representing Ndi Otuokiwu. We have people who are representing Ohanaeze and Igbo. They were not allowed access to the court today. So we insisted that the right thing must be done. After we have over 9 members of legal team representing the federal government today in court. They were in court. Lawyers. We also have over 10 members of SSS officials right inside the court. Why can't they allow at least some members of legal team defense team to be in court? So they refuse to do that. And we're outside the court door trying to resolve these challenges. The court came in, locked the door, then denied access to the court. Before we could speak to Jack Robinson, the matter has been adjourned to 19th and 10th of January. I've not seen such travesty. I've not seen travesty of justice. We are just told. We are told that the court invited our client and the DPP and the prosecutor to have a discussion with them. Even when we are not there.
Imagine.
Just like what happened on 26th of July. On 26th of June 2021, when he was taken to court without reference to court to us. And he was tried on that day without us being in court. So the same thing repeated itself today. And it's unfortunately, we are within the courtroom. We are just outside the court door and we are locked outside. I've not seen such thing in my life. And there's no order from the court, substantial in court, stating that this trial will be called out in a secret. No such order has been given. This is the height of privacy of justice. So today, and also the court, that has adjourned it. The court reviewed the guideline of persons who are visiting here.
Yes.
That guideline contained an order of court and was served on the DSS. That order was furthered by the DSS with impunity. And on the basis of that disobedience to that court order, we filed from 48 against the DSS to commit into contempt. That application is going to come out today for hearing too, because we went to find the court order. The court has a duty to protect the sanctity of this order. So we are in court today to also inform the court that the order he bared and served on the DSS was furthered with impunity. It can't continue that matter. So today, we are not even allowed to come inside the court to address the court on this point. So what you are saying as legal team, there's a clear case of denial of fair hearing as concerns the contents of the practice of the constitution. So we're going back home to strategize and take a further decision as to whether we can continue in this court or elsewhere. Because what you know is that this matter must be heard and must heard what? If the court is not willing disposed to hear this case, he will excuse himself voluntarily from country with this hearing or this case. That's what I can have to say.
Yes, what I want to say is it's very clear this was the fifth time I had come from the United States as Nnamdi Kanu's international lawyer to try to meet and see him, where I was denied 5 times. It was very clear today that I was the one that caused them to lock everybody out of the courtroom. They did not want me in the courtroom. I'm here not to create an irritant. There are huge international law issues raised by the charges against Nnamdi Kanu.